Jean-Luc Picard is back.
The flurry of praise and applause at the declaration of the return of Sir Patrick Stewart to Star Trek television has been echoed from across Trek fandom worldwide. Many are salivating with near abandon at the news and are enthusiastically prognosticating on YouTube and elsewhere about how a reprised Jean-Luc Picard will be made fresh and unique for current times. We are, after all, some 24 years beyond the series finale of Star Trek The Next Generation in 1994, and 16 years beyond the last Next Generation movie, Star Trek Nemesis, in 2002. So there is an understandable hunger for an up-to-date look at a character whom many Star Trek fans consider to be their captain, the Enterprise skipper of their generation. And there is no doubt that many are greatly anticipating a Jean-Luc Picard who in many ways will remind them of the man that led them across Federation space and beyond for seven wondrous years during the TNG era. There is, however, another view, one that is more skeptical of a revived Jean-Luc Picard, and which does not necessarily bespeak his comeback with pomp and heraldry, a view that is deeply rooted in a grave suspicion of those presently in charge of the Star Trek franchise and their motivations for returning the now 78-year-old Patrick Stewart to a role that he firmly declared more than once to be a closed chapter of his acting career. This is the position of many who have come to regard the new custodians of Star Trek as inept and lacking a fundamental understanding of what it represents. And they have evidentiary reason to think so in the form of the new CBS All Access series, Star Trek Discovery, a series that from its beginning was drowned in all manner of controversy, from its monstrous reimagining of the Klingon species to its illogical and disjointed mismanagement of Star Trek canon history. Star Trek Discovery has succeeded in making an utter mockery of the Star Trek legacy, and in the process, has succeeded in making an enemy of much of the Star Trek community. It has, without a doubt, fittingly earned the acronym by which many fans refer to it today, STD. But this is not about Star Trek Discovery as such. Instead, my case today is against the powers running Star Trek and where, based upon the evidence given to us through Star Trek Discovery, they may lead a new Jean-Luc Picard-centric streaming series. We've already been told that Jean-Luc Picard may not be the same man we knew from The Next Generation or the movies.
However, I have to tell you, he may not, and I stress may not, be a captain anymore. He may not be the Jean-Luc that you recognize and know so well. It may be a very different individual, someone who has been changed by his experiences.
And while this is not necessarily something to be nervous about, Star Trek Discovery's helmsmen have repeatedly demonstrated their willingness to create extremely malleable individuals who are inconsistent in action, attitude, belief, and philosophy, who are led not by any well-deliberated principles, but by subjectivist and relativistic ethics that are as interchangeable as their personalities. By contrast, this is not the Jean-Luc Picard of the Enterprise D, nor any other Jean-Luc Picard you know. The Jean-Luc Picard you know is the Jean-Luc Picard who fought for Data's rights to be recognized as a free and sentient being in the measure of a man. The Jean-Luc Picard who similarly fought for Data's daughter Lao's rights against the authority of the entire Starfleet bureaucracy in The Offspring. The Jean-Luc Picard who defied one of Starfleet's most revered admirals, using her own father's words to impeach her accusations of treason against a low-ranking enlisted crewman in the Drumhead. The Jean-Luc Picard who reminded Wesley Crusher of his solemn oath to tell the truth, even at the potential cost of his Starfleet career and reputation, in the First Duty. The Jean-Luc Picard who put his own command and career on the line to come to the aid of his friend and fellow Starship Captain Walker Keel in Conspiracy. And last but certainly not least, the Jean-Luc Picard who represented all of humanity to the Q Continuum at the beginning and end of the Enterprise D's seven-year journey. I could go on with a dozen more unique examples, but I think you get the picture. This is the Jean-Luc Picard you know and love, a man of principle, courage, and profound understanding of the human condition. He is one of Star Trek's most renowned and iconic characters. And if that personality is fundamentally altered and deconstructed, perhaps in a similar vein as Luke Skywalker was bastardized in The Last Jedi, what would be left of the Jean-Luc Picard whom for 7 years made you want to be an officer on the bridge of his Enterprise? Whom, when he said, "Make it so," you gladly and without the slightest reservation answered, "Yes, sir, Captain." Now don't misunderstand. I loved the TNG years. I loved Jean-Luc Picard. And I have a great respect for the man who brought that esteemed character to life all those years ago. But I cannot escape the gnawing feeling eating at my thoughts that what many are cheering for, what many are expecting, a ghost of Jean-Luc Picard past, is not the same noble human being who will be presented to us by the spokesman of Star Trek present. Instead, I am supremely worried that we will get a chimera, a stand-in, whom, though he may indeed be portrayed by the same wonderful actor, will be a far cry and then some from the captain we all knew and admired. And so, out of fellowship with you, my beloved Star Trek fans, I ask you to indulge with caution the notion that Jean-Luc Picard is back. I say these things as a warning because I do not wish to see your hearts broken, nor Star Trek fandom humiliated, should this version of Jean-Luc Picard be someone in whole or in part unrecognizable to us. Now, it may turn out that my concerns will be unfounded, that Jean-Luc Picard will still be the man of perceptiveness that we remember, only older and wiser. But with such telegraphing as has come before, in the guise of Star Trek Discovery, can we really afford to be all in for this new Picard show, charging forward to support it with reckless abandon and little other consideration ahead? I think not. And as I said about Star Trek Discovery after sorrowfully examining the evidence before me, if this new Picard series is some kind of abomination that makes a mockery out of the character and the series he popularized, then we should reject it, whole cloth, hands down, period, end of sentence. In such a case, we must reject it, because if we do not, the door will then be flung wide open, blown off its hinges as Alex Kurtzman and his ilk proceed onward to deconstruct others of our heroes and the Star Trek philosophy which they are a part. They have already signaled to us that they intend to radically alter Mr. Spock in this new Star Trek Discovery series, making him into something that is unrecognizable even to the original series itself. If they are willing to do this with Mr. Spock, then they certainly will be willing to do it with Jean-Luc Picard and at some later time, perhaps even other characters that we know and love, perhaps even James T. Kirk himself. Therefore, I say to you, Trekkies, that we are at an impasse, a crossroads of decision, and if we allow that line of decision to be continually violated, we may reach a point where there will be no going back no matter what else we do. Therefore, I charge you to be steadfast to defend the heritage we have received from the last 5 decades. Your actions may just preserve the Star Trek legacy from becoming ignominiously cast onto the ash heap of science fiction history. Until next time, Star Trek fans, live long and prosper.